put for everybody. There's this thing called the calcium score. If you have high cholesterol, your doctor sometimes encourages you to get a calcium score to see if the plaque is already building up in your arteries. So in 2009, the president's calcium score before he was president was 34. In 2013, before he was president, it was 98. Today, it's 133. And as you see from the little cheat sheet fine print below, a score of over 100 means a high risk of heart attack or heart disease within 3 to 5 years. What do you make of these findings?
Well, I mean, that's concerning. I mean, I agree with Dr. O'Connor on this point, that you want to take patients at this point in time. And I think what Dr. Jackson was saying yesterday in the White House was, we've assessed the function of President Trump's heart. They did an echocardiogram. They did a stress test, and there was not cause for concern there. But when you look at the findings you just put up there, Allison, this coronary calcium score is a score that a lot of cardiologists use to try and be predictive and be proactive. And if the number gets up over 100, that is concerning to a lot of doctors. It's concerning because you can start to say, well, if you do nothing different, if things don't change, you can start to predict the likelihood of having some sort of heart event, cardiac event, a heart attack or something like that within a certain number of years. Mm-hmm. And you see the trajectory of President Trump's numbers, no doubt, and I think Dr. Jackson alluded to this, based on, because of his diet and because of his lack of exercise, mm-hmm. that would be part of the reason those numbers have likely gone up. And they have continued to go up despite the fact that he's been on medications. Mm-hmm. So the president has heart disease. Those numbers qualify him for having heart disease, and it clearly needs a plan to try and prevent some sort of heart problem down the road.
Mm. Dr. O'Connor, does the calcium score concern you?
It concerns me, just like Sanjay said. It's evidence that, yes, they're not the coronary vessels that he was born with, but the function of his heart was better addressed by the stress echo, and they were reassuring numbers. But I look for actionable information, and this is actionable information. We know his cholesterol is suboptimal. He's on an anti-cholesterol medicine, and it sounds like Dr. Jackson's going to increase the dose of that, which is appropriate. He's on a baby aspirin a day, which is appropriate. You look at microscopic inflammation to see if any of those plaques are at risk for breaking off and going downrange. But it sounds like the things that can be reasonably done for a man with a situation are being done. The other ways to look at risk are some models that are age old. The Framingham study gave us a Framingham scale. And if you plug in the numbers we received yesterday into that, it puts them around 11%, which would be a high-low or a low-intermediate risk, which is about right.
Okay, I want to ask about his cognitive state, because questions obviously had been raised recently about that. And there was a moment that was troubling, at least to viewers, where the president slurred his speech at an event, and there was no explanation given for what was happening until yesterday. So let me play that moment to remind people.
I asked the leaders of the region, political and religious, Israeli and Palestinian, Jewish and Christian and Muslim, to join us in the noble quest for lasting peace. Thank you. God bless you. God bless Israel. God bless the Palestinians, and God bless the United States.
Okay, so people wanted an explanation. Obviously, after that, what was that? It was so different than his normal way of speaking. So yesterday, for the first time, the White House doctor explained that he had given the president Sudafed, and that causes dry mouth, and that's what happened that day. That was helpful. But Sanjay, tell us also what the doctor revealed about any cognitive test that he gave the president.
Yeah, what Dr. Jackson basically said was that at the president's request, he administered a cognitive test. And I just got to point out, I mean, I've never heard of a president getting a cognitive test in the 16 years that I've been reporting on this. So this was a bit unusual. And then
maybe it was to put to bed those questions. Maybe the President Trump wanted to put to bed those questions, so he specifically asked for it.
Yeah, I think that certainly could be the reason, but it was the president's request for this test. And, You know, to give you a little bit of a framework, this is a pretty simple test. I mean, it's about a 10-minute test. They ask you to identify certain animals on the screen, to be able to count backwards from 100 by sevens, to recite as many words as you can beginning with a certain letter, like the letter F, within a minute. You get the idea here. Draw a cube, draw a clock, things like that. Things that most people are able to do. And the president scored a perfect score, 30 out of 30, according to Dr. Jackson. This is a screening test. If you don't score a perfect score, it may give the doctors an inclination to probe a little bit more deeply. But as you point out, Allison, I think according to what we heard from Dr. Jackson yesterday, he didn't even want